Good day and welcome back. Today we're going to look at the last topic in SVM Physics Term 2, which is RC, RL, and RLC circuit in series. At the end of this video, you should be able to define the impedance and learn how to calculate the value. And then we're going to learn how to sketch those phase diagrams of each of the circuits. Before we move on, let us quickly revise on what we have learned in topic 18.1 until 18.3. We have learned about the resistance or the reactance of each of these components, which is the opposition to the current flow in AC circuit. We have learned how to derive the reactance and learn about the phase difference between the voltage and the current in the circuit. Last but not least, we also learn about the mean power dissipation in each of these components. So first, what is the impedance? It is the total opposition by each of these components to the AC current. We have learned about V equal to IR or V equal to IX before. And as for the impedance, it will be the total voltage or the applied voltage V equal to the current multiplied Z. First, we look at the RC circuit in series. So we have the AC voltage, which is V equal to IZ, and voltage across resistor, V equal to IR, voltage across capacitor, V equal to IX. So now we are going to draw the phasor diagram. Conventionally, we will draw the direction of the current is to the right, and the voltage across the resistor is in phase with the current. For the voltage across the capacitor, we have learned that it is lagging behind the current by 90 degrees. So the normal direction in the phase diagram is anti-clockwise direction. So the voltage across the capacitor will be 90 degrees in clockwise direction, which is lagging behind. So since the voltage of the resistor and the capacitor are not in phase, we cannot just add two of them directly to obtain the value of the applied voltage. Instead, we're going to treat them like the vector. Then we're going to do the Pythagoras theorem to obtain the magnitude of the applied voltage. And it is equal to the square root of VR squared plus VC squared. And since current in a series circuit is the same for each of the components, we can divide the equations with the current and we can obtain the formula of the impedance is equal to the square root of R squared plus XC squared. Next, we're going to find out the phase difference between the current and the applied voltage V. We just apply the formula of the trigonometry, which is the tangent of the angle is equal to the ratio of VC to VR, or it can also be the ratio of the reactance to the resistance. And from the phasor diagram, we can conclude that current is leading the voltage in RC series circuit. Now let's try one example from TKP in 2019. We are given with the AC voltage and it is connected to a pure capacitor of 220 microfarad. So the first question is to derive the current, which we have learned before, that the current is equal to C dV dt. Do the derivation and you can obtain the current is equal to omega CV naught multiplied cos omega t. Put in all the value given and you can obtain current as 23.49 multiplied cos 314 t. Next is to determine the reactance. That reactance is the ratio of the voltage to the current, or the reactance of the capacitor is also the reciprocal of omega C. And you can obtain the value of reactance is equal to 14.48 ohm. Here, we also can draw the phasor diagram that the current is to the right with the amplitude of 23.49 ampere, and the voltage across the capacitor and the applied voltage will be lagging behind by 90 degrees, and their amplitude is equal to 340 volts. So continue the question. You'll be given with a resistor connected in series to the capacitor to reduce the current to 2.4 ampere. We have learned that the current flowing each of the components in series is the same, that is equal to the ratio of VR to R or VC to XC, or it is equal to the ratio of the applied voltage to the impedance. So without the value of the resistance, we can use the formula of the impedance, which is equal to the ratio of voltage to the current. So take note that you are given with the peak voltage and the root mean square of the current in the question. Either you convert the value of the voltage or the current, you can do the derivation of the impedance, which is equal to V naught divided by cert 2 IRMS. Put in all the values and you can obtain the value of the impedance is equal to 100.17 ohm. And then we can find the value of the resistance by using the formula of the impedance equal to the square root of R squared plus XC squared. Put in the value and you will obtain the resistance as 99.12 ohm. So now we're going to look back the phasor diagram that we have learned. First is the root mean square of the current is 2.4 ampere and it is to the right. Next is the voltage across the resistor, which can be calculated by the formula of IR, and you will obtain 237.9 volt and it is in phase with the current. And then the voltage across the capacitor, which is lagging behind by 90 degrees, and you can obtain the value of the root mean square of the voltage across the capacitor is equal to 34.75 volt. And lastly, which is the applied voltage, it is equal to 240.4 volt. So take note that all the value given here is the value of the root mean squared. You can get their peak value by multiply CERT 2 as what we have learned before. And there's one more thing, which is the phase difference, that the current is leading the voltage by the angle of 8.3 degree. Next, we're going to look at the RC circuit in series. So the voltage across each of these components should be no problem for you at this stage. So we move on to the phasor diagram. The current and the voltage across the resistor are in phase, and we will take direction to the right as the reference. And then the voltage across the inductor is leading the current by 90 degrees in clockwise direction. So to obtain the applied voltage, we just apply the Pythagoras theorem that the V is equal to the square root of VR squared plus VL squared. And as for the impedance, it is equal to the square root of R squared plus XL squared. So both these formulas are quite similar as what we have learned in the RC circuit. And as for the phase difference, we can see that applied voltage is leading current, and the angle can be obtained by the formula of trigonometry, where the angle is equal to the inverse tangent of VL over VR, or it can be also the inverse tangent of XL over R. So we also will do one example from TKP in 2019. We are given with the AC current connected to a resistor of 2 ohm and an inductor of 5 millihenry. So here we can straight away calculate the value of the reactance, which is equal to 1.57 ohm. For a quick start, let's draw one phase diagram for a pure inductive circuit without the 2 ohm resistor. We have the current of 1.5 ampere to the right, and the voltage across the inductor is leading the current by 90 degrees. The value of the voltage can be obtained by the formula of IXL, which is equal to 2.36 volt. Now we're going to analyze the circuit. First is the impedance that we just applied the formula, and we can obtain 2.54 ohm. Now we're going to draw the phasor diagram. First is the current, which is equal to 1.5 ampere to the right, and the voltage across the resistor is in phase with the current, and it is equal to 3 watt. Next is the voltage across the inductor. It is equal to 2.36 volt, and it is leading the current by 90 degrees. And then for the applied voltage, it is 3.81 volt. And as for the phase difference, the applied voltage is leading the current, and you can obtain the angle by using the formula of the trigonometry, and it is equal to 38.1 degrees. So now we're going to move on to the last topic, which is RLC circuit in series. It is just the combination of what we have learned in RC and RL circuit. We have the AC source connected to three of these components in series. From the phasor diagram of RL and RC circuit, we can see that VL and VC is in the opposite direction. To obtain the value of the applied voltage, we can just apply the formula, which is equal to the square root of VR squared plus the square of the difference between VL and VC. And as for the impedance, it will be equal to the square root of R squared plus the square of the difference between the reactance of the inductor and the capacitor. And as for the phase difference between the current and the voltage, we can obtain the angle as the formula as shown in the slide. So either the voltage or the current leading, it depends on the value of the reactance of the inductor and the capacitor. To understand all this formula, let us directly see one example from the Kelantan second module in 2019. We are given with a series RLC circuit and the voltage across each of these components. We can directly draw the phasor diagram that the voltage across the resistor is to the right, and it is equal to 141 volt. And as for the voltage across the capacitor, it is 90 degrees lagging behind the voltage across the resistor, and it is equal to 120 volt. And then the voltage across the inductor is leading the VR by 90 degrees, and it is equal to 320 volt. From this phasor diagram, we can obtain the first resultant vector, which is the difference between VL and VC. And since VL is larger than VC, the resultant vector would be 200 volt in upward direction. So to obtain the value of the applied voltage, we just apply the Pythagoras theorem between VR and the resultant vector. And the value will be equal to 244.7 volt. And as for the phase difference, you just apply the trigonometry and you will obtain 54.8 degrees. If you understand what happened in RC and RL circuit, RLC series circuit should be not a problem for you, that you just need to obtain the resultant vector between the VL and VC. As for the conclusion of this chapter, we have learned about the impedance for each of these three circuits and about the phase difference and learned how to draw the phasor diagram. In short, the applied voltage will leading the current in RL circuit, and the current will be leading the applied voltage in RC circuit. And the phenomenon is quite similar to what happened in the pure inductor or the pure capacitor circuit. So you need to remember that in an inductor components, voltage is leading the current. And for the capacitor components, voltage is lagging behind current. So that's all for my lecture video for SPM Physics Term 2. And I hope you do enjoy my video. If you have any question or suggestion, you can leave it in the comment section below. Do leave a like and subscribe my channel. Hope to see you again in the future. Thank you.